ÖFK TV har flyttat hem till redaktionen några dagar. Det är ju full fart och det händer mycket i ÖFK just nu. Vi kan väl börja med att prata om det träningsläger som laget ska åka på alldeles strax. Man åker på onsdag till Marbella för det är en träningsmatch mot Ranheim i Trondheim alltså på måndag eftermiddag. Men träningsläget på Marbella. Ian, how do you think about the training camp in Marbella?
Yeah, we look forward to it. I think we had a great week in Cyprus and now it's nice to be back in Östersund actually and be home and spend a little time here. But of course, we look forward to the week. We've got a fantastic location, hotel, training pitches, and we've got two really competitive games. So I think it's a really, really key camp now for us in our preparation for leading up to the cup games.
But you have decided to close the training over there. Why?
Yeah, good question. There's a lot of talk around that, maybe more than there needs to be, because for me it's quite simple. This is a really, really important kind of 7 to 10 days when we're away. We get very, very few opportunities to really bring the team together, totally away from everything and just work together every day as a team on strategy, tactics, also values and things that are really important to us as a team, and do it in an environment that is focused and relaxed for the players. And sometimes that just means that we have to shut the doors and say, this is only about us, and we focus on ourselves, and then we can really focus on the things that are important to us leading up to the season, because we know when we get back, there's a big build-up to the start of the cup and the competitive games, and the noise gets a lot louder. So it's really good for us just to be able to go away in a great environment and have some peaceful time together and work hard as a group to be where we want to be for the start of the season.
But there are lots of media who want to talk to us.
Absolutely, yeah. And you know, like we said, there's always going to be opportunities when we're out there. And of course, we're going to find outlets and ways that we can discuss the things that people want to. That's really important for us to be able to have that output. But at the same time, you know, it's really important for me to create the best environment possible for training. That's my only concern, is to have the best training environment possible. And we go away and use money that's important to the club on buying a training camp, and then we want to get the best possible outcome for that. And of course, media will want to talk to us, and we're always open and ready for that, so that's no problem. But in terms of the sessions, it's important that we have absolute focus on them.
Då fick ni svar på det alltså. ÖFK TV alltså här med Ian Birchnall som har bråda dagar. And Ian, we have two really good news. Two new players we announced today.
Yes, we did. And that is fantastic news. I know that both David and myself, along with Martin, you know, we've put in a lot of work to get players in. You know, we're continuing to work hard because, I said, we need lots of players to add to the quality that we've got. If we want to go and compete, has to be a competitive squad. And I think the two additions that we made today, I'm absolutely delighted with. So really, really happy that we can bring in two players of this quality.
And you find both of them in the UK. We start with Charlie Colquhoun from Chelsea.
Yeah, Charlie was a player that was offered to me in July. I spoke with Tor-André Flo, who's a good friend of mine that works in Chelsea, and he mentioned the possibility of a loan for Charlie. So I really looked at Charlie a long while ago, and he was immediately a player that caught my eye, with fantastic technical capabilities, creative midfield player, good with the ball, can score a goal. So I think many, many good attributes that we want. He's been schooled in Chelsea and was extremely highly regarded there. As soon as David Webb came in, he was one of the first names that he mentioned. So we kind of said, yeah, we're both on the same page with that. And then I think David has worked extremely hard to get this one over the line. And I think from Charlie's perspective, you know, I don't think we were the only club that was interested in him, but I think he certainly saw the value in what we can bring to him as a football player. And I think he's made a choice all about football. And I think that's great for us to have somebody that's thinking like that.
But he's signed a contract 3.5 years long. Can we afford this?
Absolutely we can. Yeah. We everything that we do within the remit and the finances that have been set out. You know, we are not going to do anything that will ever put the club in a risk, and we do everything within our financial remit. So from our point of view, it's always, that is one of the most important things. You know, I think we sat, you know, we sit with a budget lower in the Allsvenskan than our league position would suggest, and I think that is important to us, that it's more about the resource and what we can put into players. And I think somebody like Charlie can certainly see the value of being here, developing, and it's going to be successful then for everybody.
Why does he choose Östersund?
I would say that he chose us because, firstly, perhaps the brand of football that we play is certainly going to suit the style of football that he's accustomed to. He's going to be able to get on the ball and create from midfield areas, which is really important for us. And that, and from that point of view, if that's going to be a kind of football that suits him, it's going to also improve him and certainly develop him as a football player. So I think that the environment, the way that we play, and the possibilities to develop and take the next level is 100% why he's chosen to sign for us.
Det var Charlie Colquette alltså som har skrivit på ett avtal för ÖFK med 3,5 år alltså framöver. The other one is a Swedish guy with a typical English name. Thomas Isherwood?
Isherwood. Thomas Isherwood, yeah. Yeah, Swede. So that's good to get a Swede in as well. Has a fantastic backstory. You know, was at Brommapojkarna, then went to Bayern Munich. And that's a wonderful step for a young player to go and educate themselves in a club like Bayern Munich. I spoke to him and you know, he learned so much during his time in Bayern, and that kind of educated him and gave him his grounding as a football player. He decided that he wanted to play first team football, and that was really important for him. So he took a step. It was German owners in Bradford that took him there. But you know, in England, it can sometimes be choppy to be a coach. And I think the coach that signed him was quickly out, and there's been a lot of changes in Bradford. And I think he felt that the best thing for him was to take a step away, reassess the best place for him to develop as a football player. And after speaking with him again, I think that he felt that this was a good environment for him.
Mm. And also there, why Östersund?
Yes, I think exactly the same reasons. You know,
Bayern München, Bradford, yeah, and now this.
Again, I think we provide a platform for players to grow and develop, both on and off the pitch. So, again, I think when you look at his education, he went to Bayern. I think Pep Guardiola was the manager. Don't say that he was with the first team every week, but that influence goes down throughout the club. So the way that he was played is a ball playing central defender, somebody that wants to be brave and build the play. And if you look at the identity of how we play, we want our central defenders to do the same thing. So probably he looks at us and sees the identity of which we play and think that that is going to suit him as a football player. And again, for a young player, I think this is a fantastic place to come and develop and further your career.
Mm-hmm. Lots of you have a big responsibility now.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, the squad is growing. We have a lot of talented players now, and that's what we want. You know, we need to create competition. Certainly, the squad was very thin going into the last part of the season last year, and what we want is to create a situation where there's great competition. It raises the level of training. It puts pressure on players to perform. And it gives us good options all the time to be able to change games, to influence games, to change systems. So to have a squad with quality is really important.
But now you have one goalkeeper, one defender, one midfielder and one striker to the squad.
Yeah, we're balancing it out one position at a time. And certainly there's going to be some more. So we haven't finished yet. We're going to continue to work in the transfer market. And we still have a few lined up that we hope for that we can bring through. Would be great if it's by Malaga. That would be fantastic. But, you know, the most important thing is we get the right players in at the right time.
Are you a happy man right now?
Right now, yeah. I'm happy and a little relieved. You know, it takes a lot of work sometimes to get these over line, and it's nice when we get them there. And like I say, I'm really satisfied. We had a fantastic training session as well today. So I see that the players are starting to step up now, and it's certainly, I feel that we're in a good place.
ÖFK TV alltså med två bra nyheter. Charlie Colquette, Thomas Isherwood är båda klara för ÖFK för lång tid framöver. Det är träningsmatch på måndag eftermiddag. Hoppas att ni följer oss då. ÖFK TV är tillbaka då från Trondheim.